What exactly caused the tragedy that claimed the lives of the five people on board the Titan? Here's a quick look at how extreme conditions can destroy a submersible. As opposed to an explosion, which is a rapid release of energy, an implosion involves a large force crushing an object that is incapable of withstanding that force. It is usually the result of a significant pressure differential between the inside of a vessel and the area outside of said vessel. At sea level, people are experiencing 1 atmosphere of pressure, or 14.7 pounds per square inch. This is due to the weight of the air in the atmosphere pressing down on you. As you go higher up, there's less atmosphere around you and the air pressure will drop. If you dive into the ocean, you'll experience greater pressure as water is far denser than air. At high altitudes, the low air pressure may cause breathing difficulties. Dive deep into the ocean, and the weight of all that water can crush you. To get around this, we have planes that feature pressurized cabins and submersibles that feature hulls designed to keep increased pressures out. However, when traveling in these vessels, things can go wrong. You may have seen someone get sucked through the door of an airplane or blasted out of an airlock in a movie. This is called uncontrolled decompression, and it certainly happens in real life too, as an unfortunate passenger on Southwest Airlines discovered a few years back. That's essentially the opposite of a submarine imploding, but demonstrates the consequences of an unintended pressure change at a speed our brains can comprehend. However, in the case of an implosion, pressure isn't being lost, it's forcing its way in. And the forces involved tend to be much greater, with an atmosphere's worth of pressure being added every 33 feet you go down. Unlike planes and space shuttles, which are designed to keep a pressure of around 1 atmosphere, or 14.7 psi, contained when the outside pressures are lower, a submarine or submersible is designed to do the opposite. It fends off outside pressures, so whatever is within can stay at the same pressure you would experience at sea level. A space shuttle will, at worst, have to deal with 1 atmosphere's worth of pressure differential, while a submersible will have to contend with many times that. To use one of the most extreme examples available, Titanic director James Cameron's journey to the bottom of the Challenger Deep saw his craft fending off pressures of up to 15,979 psi, or nearly 1,087 atmospheres. An implosion occurs when a pressure vessel can no longer handle the forces surrounding it. This can happen for a few reasons. In the case of a submarine, diving beyond the depth it is rated for can result in a catastrophic hull failure and subsequent implosion. If you grab a soda or beer can and squeeze, the can isn't strong enough to handle the forces you are exerting on it, and as a result, your hand will crush it. On a basic level, that is essentially what happens to a sub that dives beyond its collapse depth. Keep in mind though, catastrophic failures could also occur without a sub hitting its collapse depth. Any damage or flaws in the vessel's construction may create a weak point and subsequently cause the hull's failure. According to recent news reports, this is likely what happened to the missing Ocean Gate submersible.
The debris is consistent with the catastrophic loss of the pressure chamber.
At extreme depths, an implosion isn't exactly a blink and you'll miss it type affair. It's much faster than that. A pressure vessel would go from fine and functional to a crushed piece of wreckage faster than your brain can comprehend what has happened. If you're unfortunate enough to be on the inside of an imploding vessel, it will also be over before you even know what's going on. In the case of Titan, a catastrophic hull failure may look a little different. A large section of the pressure vessel was made of carbon fiber, which doesn't deform like metal. Instead, the material likely fractured and may have essentially disintegrated once its integrity was compromised. While the loss of the nuclear submarine, the USS Thresher, in 1963 resulted in a debris field, the vessel itself broke into 3 large pieces and the hull didn't disintegrate. Unlike the movies, a failure is unlikely to be preceded by a crack spiderwebbing its way across a porthole. Because of the forces involved, any failure would be instantaneous. The consequences for anyone inside an imploding vessel are equally swift. Organic matter is not designed to stand up to extreme forces, and with an almost instantaneous pressure change from 1 to hundreds of atmospheres, death is likely to happen before a human central nervous system can even register that something has gone wrong.